Along the White Horse Trail in the town of Oso, there was a solemn ceremony to say goodbye to a tree.
I come up every other day. I try to.
Ron Thompson's home was among those destroyed during the Oso landslide in March of 2014. He, his wife, and his mother-in-law had just left their house to go to the store when mud and debris swallowed up their five-acre property.
Just grateful. Just so grateful.
Since then, this 100-foot-tall spruce, which remained standing in the midst of the landslide, has become a memorial for the 43 people who died. But now, 3 years later, it was in danger of toppling over due to the mud that over-impacted the roots.
It's very tough. I mean, it's tough for everybody. It's hard to even want to take such a tree down.
Oso resident Chad White heads the team in charge of removing the tree. He helped in the landslide's recovery efforts, and he said this job is bittersweet.
We just don't want to forget whatever happened. I don't think we ever will.
The plan is to have part of this tree repurposed to be used as part of the permanent Oso Memorial, and families of the victims have said that they wanted it located here along the White Horse Trail.
I think it's important that it continues. It doesn't die away.
For Thompson, he says the strength of the community rooted in this tree will live on in the people who call this place home.
I don't think this is something that's ever going to fade away.
In Oso.
As far as I'm concerned, I will never let it fade away.
Petranya Poonswan, Cairo 7 News.